Good morning, students. In this session, I am going to teach you about work energy method. How to solve the problems by work energy method. In engineering mechanics, this is one of the topic in kinetics of particles. That means considering the forces, calculating the amount of forces acting on moving bodies. With that force, we will find and other parameters regarding the movement of the object. Work. What is work? The definition of work is the product of force and displacements. That's all. So here, force into distance to move an object. So see this object, this is a body, it is having a mass. In order to move the object from here to another distance, so to move to certain distance, so this is the displacement, distance moved. So in order to move the object, we need to apply force horizontally, then only the object will move in this horizontal directions. So I am applying a horizontal force having magnitude P, and with that force the object is moving from initial position to final position, and it takes a displacement S. Now what is the work completed for moving an object? So work is said to be done means, so object is, something happens, so object is moved to certain distance, then only the work is done. So here work done is equal to the force into distance. Okay, force value into distance. Okay. So see the next image. So here I am applying a force at an angle of theta with the horizontal. Okay, theta with the horizontal, but the object is moving only in horizontal direction. Here this force, I am resolving it into two components, one along the horizontal and one along the vertical. So here two components are there, P cos theta and P sin theta. So here in this, for moving the object in horizontal directions, which component is used means horizontal component, right? P cos theta only used. So this horizontal component only responsible for moving the object in horizontal direction to distance. So here the force is P cos theta only. Okay, force into distance. So we have to consider only the P cos theta term into the displacement in that directions. So this is how we can calculate the work done when the object is displaced from one position to another position. So the work done formula is force into distance moved. Okay. Next, we have derived a relations, work energy equations, work and energy. So regarding that, work and energy are same. Work is done means energy is consumed. So we are applying a force to certain distance. So work is done. So this work done is the energy. Okay, this work done is equal to, so here consider this object. Okay, this is a round object, so I am applying sigma F on horizontal force. It is displaced to certain distance. Okay, so this is the initial position, here is the final position. So here why I am used sigma F, the symbol means here in the object so many forces may act, okay, but we have to find the sigma of F, that means sum of all forces along the direction of movement, sum of all horizontal forces. Here the movement take place in horizontal direction, so we will use sum of all horizontal forces. So this force act on the object. So initially it may be at velocity u. Okay, initial velocity u. So then after initial velocity, I am applying a force. Due to that force, the body is displaced to a distance, yes. So when the body is here, the velocity may change. So this is the final velocity. So initial velocity is u and final velocity is v. Now we have to find the work done means from initial positions to final positions. Okay, initial final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy, which is the work done. That's all. Because it is a moving object. Moving object has the kinetic energy. So here we are taking two positions. So position 1 and position 2. So in order to move the object from initial position to final position, so it needs a work done. So that work done is equal to the final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. We know the formula for kinetic energy as half mv square. From that, the derived relation is this. So work done. So here from initial to final work done is sigma f into distance moved, which is equal to final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. Here sigma f means sum of all the horizontal forces, and s means displacement, w means weight of the body, u means initial velocity of the body, and v is the final velocity. So with that equations, we can able to solve the unknown values in this. So here let us solve one problem. A body of mass 600 newton, so weight is given, weight is 600 newton, is placed on a 20 degree inclined plane, is placed on a 20 degree inclined plane. So see the image, 20 degree inclined plane, on that a body is placed and pulled by 500 newton force applied parallel to the plane, and pulled by 500 newton force. So here in the image, so 500 newton force is pulled, acting in this direction along the plane. It is acting as shown in the figure. Figure is given in the question. If the initial velocity is given as 2 meter per second, calculate the final velocity v. Okay, we need to find the final velocity v. When it has traveled a distance of 2 meter, the displacement also 2 meter. Take the coefficient of kinetic friction as 0.2. That's all. So how to solve this? With the help of work energy equations. So here we are going to solve this problem with the help of work energy equations. So here in this, in work energy equations, so already we studied, right? So here what are the things we need means we need sigma f, sum of all horizontal forces, sum of all the forces along the direction of motion. That's all. This is not a simply horizontal force, sum of all forces along the direction of motion. Okay, so here in this problem, where, in which direction it, the body will move? The body will move in the, move along the plane, along the plane. Okay, this inclined plane, along this inclined plane. Okay, along this inclined plane only the body will move. Okay, so that direction. So I take that direction as x-axis. Okay, along the plane, I take it as x-axis. So 190 degree from x-axis, one perpendicular axis, which is y-axis. Okay, now we can calculate sigma f, sigma x. Okay, sigma x means sum of all forces in x direction. That means the along the direction of motion. So just we have to find sigma f. Displacement is given in the question. So w means weight is given, g is acceleration due to gravity 9.81, v means final velocity, so this is the required parameter we need to find, and u is the initial velocity, which is also given in the question. Just v only the unknown value, so we have to find. So before that, we have to find sigma f, that means sum of all forces along the direction of motion of the body. So the object is moving along the plane. So I take along the plane as x and perpendicular to the plane as y. So along the plane means x-axis. So we have to find the sum of all forces along the
explain. Okay. Okay. So here in this,
so first we have to understand what are the forces acting on the body. So this is an object. So here this body is placed on the inclined plane and I am applying 500 Newton in this direction. So the body will move along this direction of the applied force. Okay, here 500 Newton force is acting in along the plane. So the body will move upwards along the plane. So what are the forces means? First, initially this external force is acting 500 Newton. Then weight of the body. Weight of the body. Weight means total mass of the body. Okay, total mass of the body, which is given in the question also as 600 Newton. This weight always acting downwards. We know this is 600 Newton along downwards direction. That's all. Okay, wherever it may be the object, where if it is maybe inclined plane or horizontal plane or wherever, always the weight will acting towards downward direction. So this 600 Newton is there. So this 500 Newton external force, then self weight, weight of the body, 600 Newton acting. So then any other forces acting means some more forces are acting, because this body is in contact with the surface. Okay, this body is in contact with the inclined surface. So in other words, I can say like this body is supported in this inclined plane. It is supported. Supported means what it means? So it is supported, it is resting on this inclined plane. Resting means it is not moving. So if the object is moving downwards, so if this inclined plane is not there, means what will happen? This weight is acting. So this weight pulls the body towards downwards. This body tried to move downwards due to the own weight. But this body is not moving downwards because it is supported by this inclined plane. Okay, this is supported. That means what? So it is supporting this weight. Okay, this is supporting this weight. That means support reaction is acting. And reaction force is acting. Okay. Only because of that reaction force, the body is at rest. If the reaction force is not acting means, so surface will not be there. The body will move down. The 60 Newton force is acting, right? Acceleration due to gravity, 9.81, this will act. The object will not moving downwards. So this supported. This surface will give an opposite reaction. So this is Newton's third law of motion. Okay. Action and reaction. So action force is the weight. Reaction force will be opposite to the action force. So here the surface, the reaction force always act perpendicular to the surface. So here this inclined surface. So it act perpendicular to the surface. So here NR. So the green color. One force is there, no? This force is the reaction force. Normal reaction NR. This reaction force is acting. So we studied about that. One external force, one weight is acting, one support reaction is acting. Support reaction is acting because it is supported on this inclined plane. So this support reaction always act perpendicular, normal to the surface which is supporting. And one more force is acting, which is a friction force. The object is moving with the contact. Always it is keeping in contact with the surface. So friction force is acting. So because the object is in contact, two surfaces are in contact. The surface of the body and the surface, inclined plane, which is in contact and the body is moving. So friction force is tangential to the contact surface. One frictional force is acting. So this is red color, one frictional force. Frictional force always acting in the opposite direction of the motion, movement. So this is moving upward along the plane. So the friction will move in opposite direction of the movement. Always it resist motion. It resist motion means it will be in the opposite direction of the motion of the body. So this is F. So these are all the forces. So here we have external force, one weight, one normal reaction, one friction. then we have to resolve these forces along x-axis and along y-axis. So here 500 Newton force is along x-axis, no problem, and F is along x-axis, no problem, it is resolved. Nr is along the y-axis, which is also no problem, but now this 600 Newton is having inclined with the x-axis. Okay, so I have to convert into its components, one along x-axis, one along y-axis. Okay, I marked this. So we have to split this 600 Newton into two components, one along x-axis, one along y-axis. So here along x-axis, the component is 60 sin theta, because the angle is with y-axis. So this 20 degree, right? This 20 degree is along with the y-axis. So y-axis component become cos theta, 600 cos theta. Then the x-axis component will 600 sin 20. That's all. Now we resolved all the forces. Here how many forces are acting? This 500 Newton, this 600 sin 20, 600 cos 20, this F and Nr. Then just to find. So here we can use sigma V equal to 0. This relation we can use, because the object is not moving in vertical direction, right? This is supported. In vertical direction, the object will not move. That means vertical force is cancelled. Sigma V equal to 0. So here how many vertical forces? Nr towards up positive, and this 600 cos 20 is downward negative. We will get the value of Nr. Once we get the value of Nr, we can find the value of F friction. We can find the value of F. The F value, formula for F is mu Nr, mu into Nr. Mu means coefficient of friction, which is given in the question. Nr we find. Then let us find the sigma Fx. Sigma Fx means sum of all forces along this x-axis. So here on 500 Newton towards down, towards right side, plus 500, then F is in the towards left, minus F. Then 600 sin towards left. Then here you have friction force. The value of friction, the formula is mu into Nr. Nr we already find with sigma V is equal to 0 equation. Then we find, substitute here, we will get sigma Fx. After finding sigma Fx, we can substitute in the work energy equation. Sigma F into S equal to W by 2G into V square minus U square. Here sigma F we found. S displacement is given in the question. Then weight is 600, G 9.81. We substitute here. And after that, we find the value of V as 3.987 meter per second. So this is the answer.